Dear Cal, it's been years since I moved away from Macon. About 4 years to be exact. New York's a lot different from Macon. Everyone bustling to get to destinations of unknown. As many people say, the city never sleeps. It's lonely in the big city, booming with open positions and mysterious adventures. Being a writer has its ups and downs in the city, but life goes on. Late last night, from the balcony of my apartment complex, I thought of my childhood I remember strongly of. I know, I was a stubborn child, and I'm thankful, Cal, that you were able to control me. Well, sort of. How the memories come back to me. Remember Charles Baker Harris? I reckon you probably remember him as Deal, who became my childhood friend and my partner. When we first met that day in Miss Rachel's yard, Jim and I were searching for puppies, only to find a young boy reading a book. Jim, Deal, and I grew close, and I figure you remember how we kept you busy with our childish ways. Like our Boo Rally obsession phase. Innocence was written all over my childhood. Do you still remember how strong my dislike for dresses and feminine objects was? I still feel uncomfortable about it, but you didn't care about what I wore, only the manners I displayed. Then, when I was in elementary school, it was difficult for me in the early years. Atticus and you were tough on me at times, mostly when Walter Cunningham came into the picture. I remember beating him up for something he didn't do, and I remember how it was hard on him for the way he ate. After all, to me, he was just a Cunningham and nothing more. But you told me it didn't matter who he was. I soon realized that afterwards, and did my best to make it up to him. Even when Aunt Alexandra called him trash, I cried for him. But it was then that I respected folks like him. Christmas time was a bummer years later. It was close to the trial, and we spent the holidays at the Finch's Landing. I hated how Aunt Alexandra criticized me about my choice of outfit and Atticus's way of raising Gemini. Her words later reminded me of Mrs. DuBose had said to me about my tomboyish ways. I couldn't forget Francis either. Aunt Alexandra's grandson who had a mouth I had to punch. Atticus had told me not to hurt anybody no matter what they say. But I couldn't handle it no more. He deserved what he got, but no others begged to differ. I had confidence that I did the right thing. No one thought I did at first, but I showed Uncle Jack wrong. I truly did try to hold back and respect Atticus's wishes and warning, but I was a headstrong child who had a mouth of her own. The trial was big back then. I remember the night before when Jim, Dylan, and I sneaked out when Aunt Alexandra went to bed to find Atticus outside of the old jail. A group of men was with him, though I didn't know it at the time that they were there to hurt Atticus and Tom Robinson before the trial. So I ran up to them, and with my innocence and awkwardness, saved Atticus and Tom by greeting Mr. Cunningham, telling him good things about his son. I was naive at that point, and I didn't understand a thing I said wrong, till now, when I realized that it was sort of rude and childish to be talking about how much money he owed. The next day, the trial took place, and I swore to Jim that I knew I understood the trial. But now, I look back and realize I didn't. It was an unfair and biased trial that I never will forget. The fate of that man was horrible, his life torn away. It took Macon by storm. Everyone was talking about it, including Aunt Alexandra's friend she had tea with. You were there serving, and I tried to help you. I disliked the dress I had to wear. Though it was a ladies' party, it was nothing but inappropriate. The conversations were about Atticus and the outcome of the trial. I swear, I was in a room full of improper, mouthy women. But I stood brave and strong in my pink dress, trying to be the lady everyone wanted me to be. After all, if Auntie could do it, be a lady like that, so could I. During 1933 to 1935, my childhood during the Great Depression impacted how I turned out to be today. Compassionate, understanding, respectful, and wise, all because of you, Atticus, and the people of Macomb. It's sad to hear you losing your memory, Cal. I'll be home to visit soon. From your very own, Jean Louise Finch Harris.